Assalamu alaikum, dear students. I hope you will be enjoying these videos and learning so many things also, and you might be increasing your vocabulary also. So these things are very interesting. If you take interest in your studies, it will be a matter of great interest for all of you. So let us start next. This is a creative writing. How to do the creative writing? Number one thing is commitments, essentials for life. It's very important that we must be committed. Whatever the things we feel, we say that these are good, we must be committed to that. So education helps us to live a better life in a disciplined manner. We have no doubt about it. It helps us to form habits and a better style of living. Obviously, the main purpose of education is to have a better style of living, to have a better life. Now you have to choose one commitment. Just four commitments are given over here. Choose one commitment which you want to adopt from the list given below, and you can present it also in the class as we are having these online classes. That is why I'll discuss all these commitments in some detail. Take care of personal hygiene without being told to do so. Personal hygiene, this is important. You should try to take bath daily, and similarly, be careful about the cleanliness of your feet, cleanliness of your nails, cleanliness of your hair. And without noticing, without being told to it to the other people, you have to take care about personal hygiene. And then where we live, it must also be clean. So the second commitment is use a broom and dustpan properly. Means there is nothing insulting about it when we are using a broom or a dustpan. There is nothing insulting about it. We can clean our own room. We can clean our classroom. There is nothing insulting about it. And next is take out the trash and carry it to the garbage collection point. You can do this activity always. We must be committed to throw the trash and carry the garbage to the collection point. And then keep your classroom neat and clean. This is also very important. Where 60 students are sitting, then obviously it is difficult for one person to keep that classroom clean. We always say that sweepers, they don't bother, they don't come, they don't clean our classroom. These are just the lame excuses. We can do so many things to make our classroom clean. For example, the wrappers, the waste papers, they should always be thrown in the dustbin. There should be no such thing on your desks. And similarly, we should always try to keep the things clean over there in the classroom. And this is not only the job of the sweeper to do all cleaning. It is a job of every one of us who is sitting in this classroom, who is enjoying studies in this classroom, that we have to keep our classroom neat and clean. So we have to make commitments that we will take care of our personal hygiene, and we will not feel any insult while taking the garbage or trash to the dustbin to the points where these are collected. And we should always try to keep our classroom neat and clean. It is needed that every one of us must make this commitment. Then we come to the next point, that is art of writing poetry. Now you have listened the recitation of a poem. It is an interesting form of writing, and many of you might have the germs of poetry in you, and you might be able to write your own poems. We can express ourselves freely in poetry. You can write poetry on any topic on earth. Whatever you feel, you can write. But there are certain rules which need to be followed for certain styles. So it is a great way, it is a great mean of expression of feelings. Anyone can write poetry. Just pick up a pencil and begin practicing. Some of the important stages are, you must have some idea for that. Begin with an idea. You must have some idea when you are going to write the poetry. For example, the poem that we have just recited, we have just read, that is all about the commitment. And the idea, the main idea behind the poem is commitment. Next is brainstorm. It is also a technique. Whatever the ideas that come in your mind, just write them at some place. This is called brainstorming. And then organize your thoughts. Obviously, the next stage is the ideas have come. Now you have to organize your thoughts in a proper way. Use rhyming words. Obviously, it will look good and rhythm should be there in the poetry. Use a lot of descriptive words. Description should be there in poetry. And you can read different poems for your inspiration. Because reading, that always makes a man perfect. So not only the poem that is given in your book, but also you can read other poems also for your inspiration. And in this way, you can write poem also. That will be a very good activity for you for the expression of your emotions. Then we come to the next activity, that is a flyer making for a campaign. Flyers, they are a great way to get your messages to the general public. Now prepare a flyer for the people around your home and school to make the campaign. Clean and Green Pakistan, a great success. The guidelines that are given over here are, number one, include the basic. Make sure your flyer states the who, what, where and when of what you are trying to communicate. Go for eye-catching imagery. If it is not interesting, nobody will like to see that flyer. Flyer design is important to use images that will grab people's attention. Obviously, if it is not interesting, nobody will like to see the flyer. Now keep it brief. When, if comes to text, less is more. Too many words will detract from your imagery and the essential information. It means that it must be very small, just like a slogan. Otherwise, people will not see that flyer. If it is too much in detail, nobody will like to see that flyer. A simple flyer that is given over there, that is for Clean and Green Pakistan. Flag of Pakistan that is there, a tree that is there, it is conveying the idea of Green Pakistan. A flyer that is there in your book that is conveying the idea of Green Pakistan. In this way also you can make the flyer. So this is an activity that you can do in your vacation and it will be a very interesting one. You can take half of the chart paper and make the flyer of your choice. For example, about healthy food, you can make the flyer. A template is also given over here. Title, picture, objectives, venue, all these things are also written over here. Sample is given. You can make your own flyer. For example, you may write about healthy food. You may write about importance of traveling. It's on your own choice. Whatever you like, you can make the flyer. Then we come to the next point, that is the fluency of expression. That is the quotes collection. Quotes. Now what are the quotes? Quotes are form of direct speech and should always be written within quotation marks. Or quotation marks, they are also called as the inverted commas. The name of the author should be acknowledged, means it should be there. When we write the quote, always try to write the name of the author also. Using quotes in your written and spoken expression adds value to it. For example, you are writing an essay. You can write the quotes. It will increase the value of your essay. It will increase the value of your expression. Similarly, when we are talking, if we are using certain quotes, then your speech that becomes very rich and people will like to listen to your speech. Some quotations are given over here. 5 quotations are given on the topic of commitment as the main topic which was discussed in this chapter. That is of commitment. That is why they have given this the quotations also on the topic of commitment. And now you have to learn and practice in daily speech how these are used. Now, number one, that is of Abraham Lincoln. The name of the person that is given, who was the president of America. And the quotation is, commitment is what transforms a promise into reality. By commitment, we can change promises into reality. When we are committed, then we can change the abstract things like promises which are not seen into real things. This was said by Abraham Lincoln. Number two, second quotation is, stay committed to your decisions, but stay flexible in your approach. In your approach means the thing which you want to achieve, the things that you have decided, we must be committed to that. We can acquire different ways to gain that object. Stay flexible. You may change your approach from one way. If you can't gain the success, you can use another way for that. This was said by Tom Robbins. Commitment is an act, not a word. Jean Paul Sartre. This was also the name of a philosopher. Commitment is an act, not a word. So, when you do not act on your commitment, these are just the words. Words having no value without act. Actions are important, not just the words. It is very easy to say, it is very difficult to act. So, commitment, that is actually action, not just the words. Now come to the next, that was said by Winston Churchill. I am easily satisfied with the very best. So always try to gain the best. Always try to strive for the best. Always try to gain the first, the most important thing, and not the second best. When we try to achieve 100%, then actually we will be able to achieve the best. So it is very important that our views, our ideas, they must be very high. Then we come to the next point, that is the next quotation, that is of Margaret Thatcher, who was the Prime Minister of England. You may have to fight a battle more than once to win it. We must never be disheartened. We must always try again and again. It's not necessary that we gain success in first attempt. If we are not able to gain success in first attempt, we have to try that again and again. Or we have to attempt that in some different way. So you may have to fight a battle more than once to win it. So try again and again to win the battle to gain success in your life. So I think it's enough for today's. Thank you very much.